Hey, God, fucking everything up!
They're so loud.
Where did I grow up? I was born in Mississippi, grew up in Louisiana, and I was a bad kid. Elton John, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, Led Zeppelin, Houses of the Holy, and the Ramones, Road to Ruin. Between those three is pretty much what you get. Well, the Ramones, because it was relatively easy. I couldn't play Led Zeppelin shit, you know. But yeah, I think my biggest dude of all of them was Angus Young when I was really young, you know. I had pen pals in Australia and stuff. Pretty ridiculous. A girl I knew in high school knew those guys and was in New Orleans and said they were looking for a singer. She thought I'd be good. So I kind of knew these guys prior from seeing them a bunch of times. And one thing led to another and I ended up going up there, and the singing thing wasn't going. We still wanted to try and find a singer, but we tried to do the two guitar thing. I ended up singing Vote with a Bullet. And then the next record was Deliverance, and it just kind of took off from there. It wasn't an intentional thing, it just kind of fell into place, and that was it. Deliverance was recorded with another bass player, Phil Squishy, who played on Blind. Mike Dean came back in the band, started playing all, redid all the bass tracks, and he pretty much said, why don't you just do it? Yeah, we went to Europe just to play some shows and see what was happening, and see if we could still play, and you know, once we started doing the songs and everything and having fun doing it and going backwards and checking these things out, some of these songs we haven't played in a very long time. And it just kind of fell together. Once again, you know, I ain't gonna try to figure this shit out. You know, I gave up trying to do that a long time ago. Just kind of got to roll with it, man. And it took on a life of its own, and then Nuclear Blast gave us a phone call, asked us if we were interested in doing a record, gave us a really good offer, and the freedom to do whatever we wanted to, when we wanted to do it. And we couldn't pass that up. And you know, I knew Monty Connor for a long time, liked him. Thought he ran all the things he's done over the years have been great in my eyes. And so we went from there. It took us 2 years to do the record, but it's right. We kind of went off of the extension of the last thing I did, In the Arms of God, which I was really proud of that record. That was as good as I could do something. So we kind of started using that as a catalyst to move forward. But at the same time, looking back at some of these songs, it was, you know, you don't realize it until now after the record's done, when you're in the middle of it, doing everything. Sometimes going backwards can be a good thing. And I think a lot of bands don't do that. I think a lot of bands probably should. Anyway, so yeah, it just kind of fell into place, man. There was really a lot of stream of consciousness kind of stuff going on, just writing songs and off the cuff, and Custer there at the helm, and you know, putting your dick on the chopping block and just going for it. You know, this is the way it's gonna be. We do have the luxury of traveling around the world and seeing a lot of things, and I do, from my opinion of traveling as much as I have and the band has, I don't think many of us are really that far apart from each other. I think people make things a lot more complicated than it really is, you know. And especially when you're playing music like we do and you see the youth-oriented thing around the globe, everybody's pretty fucking cool, man. It's really not fucking rocket science, you know? Yeah, I think in general, people are pretty damn good.